Hi, everyone. What I want to talk about today is an exercise I created a long time ago to help learn the neck a little bit better. And what it consists of is a series of one octave scales played on the same note on a bunch of different strings. Probably sounds like it doesn't mean anything. So to give you an idea of what I'm talking about, I'm just going to play it once really fast so you'll see what it looks like and kind of get an idea in your head, and then I'll go through it slowly to give you an idea of what to basically teach to you so you can use it yourself. So here's how it goes. It continues for a while. So as you see, it's a series of one octave scales. I was doing major scales right there that start on each of the low four strings, and it plays on the same note on each string. So for instance, it started out with all C's. C, 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 and C. So in order to play this, you're gonna need to know a few different things. The first thing you need to know is one octave scales starting on each of those four. So I was doing major as well, teach you right now, but this works with all sorts of types. You can do it with minor scales, you can do it with arpeggios, you can do it with, you know, anything. So the easiest way for me to teach you these scales, if you don't know them, is I'm going to teach them to you down in the first position. And so the first scale, starting in the low E, looks like this. And what it consists of, what the frets are, what the fingers are, is on the low E string, we're going to be starting on this 2nd fret. So it's 2nd fret, 4th fret, 1st fret on the A string, 2nd fret on the A string, 4th fret on the A string, 1st fret on the D string, 3rd fret on the D string, and 4th fret on the D string. So it's 2-4, 1-2-4, 1-3-4. And I'm only going to go through each of these once, but if you ever want to learn anything again, you know, because it's a video, you can always go back and look at it, and there shouldn't be any issues with that. So with the starting on the A string, it's the same exact pattern. It looks exactly the same. 2nd fret on the A string, 4th fret on the A string, 1st fret on the D string, 2nd fret on the D string, 4th fret on the D string, and then going up to the G string, 1st fret, 3rd fret, 4th fret. So again, it's 2-4, 1-2-4, 1-3-4. Starting on the D string, it looks a little bit different because there's the shift. You have to shift off a fret to compensate for, there's the major third between the G and the B string. So it starts off 2nd fret, 4th fret, 1st fret on the G string, 2nd fret on the G string, and 4th fret on the G string. And then going up 2nd fret on the B string, 4th fret on the B string, and 5th fret on the B string. So again, that's 2-4, 1-2-4, and then 2-4-5. And then finally on the G string, it's going to look a little bit different again because of the major third between those two strings, the G and the B. It'll start out 2-4, and then the B string, 1st fret, 2nd fret, 4th fret. I screwed that up, I'm sorry, I confused that. It's 2-4, and then 2-3-5. And it'll make sense why I'm doing it like this. Oh, yeah, you can already see. And then on the E string, it's 2-4-5. So again, that's 2-4, 1, or 2-3-4-5. Wow, 2-3-5. And 2-4-5. And then I also do start each scale starting on the pinky, just because it's just another way to play the scales. It kind of forces you to repeat some of the notes, so it's just a nice extra thing to add. So I'm going to teach you those also. I'm going to start on the 5th fret with pinky, so 5 on the low E. On the A string, it's 2-4-5. On the D string, it's 2-4-6. So again, and then on the G string, it's 2. So it's 5 on the E, 2-4-5 on the A, 2-4-6 on the D, and then two on the G. Starting on the A string, it's the 5 on the A. On the D string, it's 2, 4, 5. Yep. On the G string, it's just 2 and 4. And then on the B, it's 2, 3. So again, that's 5, 2, 4, 5, 2, 4, and then 2, 3. And then the last one is starting on the D string is 5. And then it's 2, 4, 5. And then on the B string, it's 3, 5. And then on the high E, it's 2, 3. So again, that's 5, 2, 4, 5, 3, 5, and then the high E, 2, 3. So playing them all. So how this works in the exercise is you do each one on the different strings on one note. You pick one note. So for instance, you pick C and you do all the C's. So that's basically the gist of it. So I'll do kind of a sample for you picking all the different C's. So first, starting the low E, the C is on the 8th fret. So, and then you move up to the A string. And on the A string, the C is on the 3rd fret. And then you move up to the D string, and the C is on the 10th fret. And then you move up to the G string, and the C is on the 5th fret. And then doing the scales that start with the pinky, you start with the pinky on the 8th fret. And then going the A string, the C is on the 3rd fret, and because you're starting with your pinky, it's easier to probably do it with the pinky on the 15th fret, just one octave up. Ah. That. And then on the D string, the C is on the 10th fret. So those would be the 7 different C's. And so how you practice this is you just do those all in succession. And one thing I'd recommend when doing this exercise, and really most every exercise, is I do it with a metronome. The reason is that a metronome just kind of keeps you honest. It forces you to go at the same consistent speed, and it forces you to kind of think faster, which will be good because it'll help you push yourself and slowly learn these different scales. And so I'd pick a speed that I'm comfortable with. I'm going to do a chord note at 88 beats per minute, just because it's a little bit it's fast enough where you'll see them all go. And just do it like this. That's all 7 of the C scales. And so after that, now that you've done all the C's, we can you can move on to another note. I wouldn't recommend going just like chromatically. Don't go C, C sharp, D, D sharp, because with that you can just kind of shift up one fret with each one, or shift down if you're going down chromatically. I suggest going around in the circle of fourths or fifths. So I'm going to use the circle of fourths. So I just did all the C's, and after that I'll move to all the F's. And if you don't know the circle of fourths or fifths, I'll put them down in this post so you can see them. So we did all the C's and then move on to all the F's. So for instance, with the F's, the F on the E string is on the 13th fret. And then on the A string, it's on the 8th fret. And on the D string, it's on the 3rd fret. On the G string, it's on the 10th fret. And so how it's going to look when you chain it together is going to be like this. Ah. Yeah. There you go. So, yeah, and just keep going around the circle of force till you reach back at C. And, you know, it's something I found it helps a lot because it makes you think individually of where all the different notes are. And if you do it a few times each day with a metronome, you'll be surprised how quickly you'll learn the whole neck and you'll be able to use it more comfortably. And so it's something I'd like you to try, and tell me what you think about it. You know, give it a shot and let me know. So thanks for your time, and hope this was helpful. All right, bye.